Jones.
My name is Isabella Deland.
My name is Samantha Schmidt.
My name is Allie Pingleton.
We proudly represent Junior Troop 89215.
We will be performing When I Grow Up
from Matilda the Musical by Tim Minchin.
Hello, my name is Stacy Smith. I proudly represent Troop 8355. I will be performing Jamie from Between Mars and Me by Rose Helsinger and Sandra from What the Well-Dressed Girl is Wearing by Arthur M. Jolly. I lost you. My brother cast a long shadow. He beat me at chess in every game we played. He never let me win. He cared about his grades and shaved every morning at 6 a.m. He baked coffee cake with mom and delivered pizzas to help us make ends meet. I love my brother. I miss him. I don't understand what happened or why I might never see him again. I look at you and I see a ghost of him. I look at you and I wait for him to come home. Say something. I thought when I opened the curtains and you saw people, the world, that you'd get better. You stopped talking about aliens and I thought it was over, but it's not, and I don't know what to do. Tell me what to do. Tell me how to help you. Fine. I can't do this anymore. I'm leaving. I'm not coming back. Why would I be mad? Just because it's a double date and my guy's not gonna be there because I made him up. So it's just gonna be me and you and your date, Jimmy. Perfect, perfect Jimmy. And his dimples. I mean, it's Jimmy. He doesn't want to go out with me. He wants to go out with you. And he doesn't like me, even though, you know, I've been completely and utterly in love with him since second grade. I left all those little presents on his desk, and I hung around by his locker every day. And I put up a tent in the backyard and slept there with that big Valentine's Day sign I made. I was there a week. He was at his uncle's. Then when the sign didn't work, I thought, you know, bigger. Maybe he just couldn't read my handwriting. So I spent everything I had on a huge billboard that said, Jimmy, I love you. Ask me to spring formal. But I spent all my money on the billboard and couldn't afford the ticket. I just stood and watched from the window. It was raining. I stood in the rain and watched you and Jimmy dancing together. You were staring into his eyes the whole time. Eyes you could lose yourself in. And then I got bit by a raccoon.
Hello, my name is Carson Jones.
And my name is Caden Jones. We proudly represent
Junior Troop 89215.
We will be performing
Anything You Can Do from Stage Production, Any Get Your Gun
by Irving Berlin.
Look better than you.
In my coat.
In your
I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can. Yeah. No.
Proudly representing Junior Troop 89215. I will be performing The Very Bad Girl Scouts by John P. McEnany and A Sense of Belonging by Joe Smarnan.
Look, we obviously have a problem here. They could take my badges away. I could be excommunicated. I could be ousted. I could be killed. I ate them all. I know the Girl Scouts. I know what's at stake. You have to help me hide the wrappers and the boxes. My mom is going to be home from bingo any minute, and we have to hide the evidence. We can bring them out by the septic tank. I ate them all, Burton. I'm a terrible person. I couldn't help it. I was weak. I came home from school, and I had, like, the worst day ever. Everyone made fun of my new pants. And my mom forgot to make dinner. Again. And I was waiting here alone for you to come over. So I went out into the garage to look at the boxes I was looking at order for the troop. A giant wall of green boxes filled with all hope and promise of girlhood, the American dream of camaraderie, lanyard making, and outdoor sports all promised, and a tiny little cookie. And all started so simply. Just one. At first. A burst in the cookiness and chocolate-covered hue, the cold, dry bottom hitting my tongue, and the gentle but crisp snap of wafer. I ate the Thin Mints, all 17 boxes. Boxes belonging to neighbors, friends, members of my church group, my mom's co-workers at the Friendly Fish Forum. I've let down everyone. Everyone. Pepper, Rashida, Mad Dog, Tostito, Frankie, Miss Lick, my grandmother, the whole troop. I'm going to be the laughingstock of Consumption, New Jersey. I want to feel at ease when I go to school. I want to feel like I fit in. I'm never a part of the crowd, always just on the outskirts looking in. I like to be part of the action for once and not be so in my head. God, I hate being so shy, and I hate how everyone seems to think I'm that girl. And there's never a second chance of ever being included in something because I'm that girl. The girl who doesn't go to parties because I'm never invited to any, and the girl who doesn't talk to guys because guys don't talk to me. I want to change people's perspective of who I am, but I don't know how to make that work. It's like I'm there, but non-existent in a way. Does that make sense? It'd be nice to be involved with everyone, but it just doesn't seem like there's ever any room for me. Like, all the seats have already been taken. It sucks.
Hi, my name is Maggie Richard, and I proudly represent Troop 8355. I am singing Lifeboat from the musical Heathers by Lawrence O'Keefe and Kevin Murphy.
Pushing, everyone's fighting, storms are approaching, there's nowhere to hide. If I say the wrong thing, you're proudly represent Junior Troop 89215. I'll be performing Blood, Sweat, and Cheers by Amy Gentry and Casey Wheeler, and Underwhelmed by Joseph Arnett.
Couldn't take the pressure, I guess.
She was driving Lexi all over the place before she finally took me in the face of regionals. Broke her nose and got 14 stitches right under her eye. A different angle and it could have popped out clean. After that, she was never the same again. Couldn't even land a standing back. They say her mom had to hire a shrink to come in the car with her to practice, or else she wouldn't go. One day, her mom dropped her off, but Parker didn't show up on the map. Lexi found her under a bench in the lobby. Ugh, whatever. The point is, some girls just can't cut it. I'm sorry to say, you're one of them. So don't go local on us, okay? Nationals are coming up, and we really can't afford to babysit another psycho. No problem. Looks like track isn't exactly kept you in shape. And as soon as Coach K figures that out, you can go right back to Loser Town and stay there. I'm underwhelmed. Nothing impresses me or excites me. I'm amazed by nothing. I'm numb to this world and everything in it. I go through life with one face that doesn't move. I never smile, laugh, cry, frown. I'm a hollow vessel, and my thoughts are empty. Yeah, my friend tells me I should seek adventure. I tell my friend that there is nothing adventurous. I work in the mail department. I do the mail. I meet all kinds of personalities, and I mean the happy people, stressed people, and idiot people. An invisible shield has enveloped my being, and my eyes are clogged with fog. Nothing reaches me, and I reach nothing. Existence is only breathing, silently.
Hello, my name is Dory Sauer, and I proudly represent Junior Troop 89215. I will be performing I Don't Need a Roof from the play Big Fish by Andrew Lippa. Thank you.
William Broussard, and I proudly represent Junior Troop 89215. The piece I'll be performing for you today is Red Ryder Carbine Action BB Gun from A Christmas Story by Clark Hallam. You don't need a steed to be a cowboy. No, you're not a hero just by galloping off in the sun. But you really need to be a cowboy, fearless, keeping bandits trembling on the run. This is Red Ryder Carbine Action BB Gun. Protect the neighborhood so owls are always undone, and I'll bombard them from that window. Show those weasels how the Wild West was won. Bang, bang! Red Ryder Carbine Action BB Gun. Cause Randy could be kidnapped by a pack of goons. Our house might be invaded by raccoons. A tiger could escape the zoo and try to rip his shoes in two, but she would be okay. I'll swoop in and save the day. And the girls of science say, oh, Ralphie, when you're big and pregnant, we know bully can never make fun. All kids are crying, Cowboy Ralphie, while my old man shouting, that boy, he's my son. Red Ryder Carbine Action BB Gun.
Hello, my name is Donnie Fondon, and I proudly represent Junior Troop 89215. I shall be presenting The Book of Mormon by Trey Parker, Robert Lopez, and Matt Stone, and Little Pieces That Chip Away at Your Happiness by Joseph Arnell. Well, it's just you and me now, companion. According to rule number 72, we're never allowed to go anywhere without each other, except the bathroom. Which is amazing, because all of my friends, they always end up leaving me. But you can't pass. So, favorite movies? Are you a Star Wars guy? Are you a Star Trek guy? I personally like Star Wars more, but I'm willing to like Star Trek even more if you think it's better. It's the little pieces that chip away at your happiness. That's what adds up and takes its greatest toll on you. I put away so many of my problems, and yet they keep circling back to visit me. I push them away, and sooner or later they come back. I wish I could just take my brain out of my skull and give it a good rinse and polish, and only keep the best things, like my fondest memories. There's so much pollution. It gets in your eyes, your ears, your nostrils, your pores. It gets everywhere. Germs, festering, always building in strength. You think a holiday is the answer, but all it is just an excuse to put away your problems for a while. And as soon as you come back, your problems will be waiting for you, in line, like disciplined soldiers, ready to take their turn in the firing squad of your life. So you yourself must become a soldier, not just a soldier, but an absolute savage, so you can gobble up all of your enemies. Yes, you must do this to those against you. You have to be able to survive without food and water and load shelters. You have to be more cunning, faster, stronger. You have to be focused at all times. At all times, you have to be focused. You have to be able to endure massive amounts of browbeating, abuse, and death. Yes, you must even overcome death, because in death is when you reach your ultimate power. The little pieces that chip away at your happiness, they may be tough, but when you're crazy enough, you just might make it out.
And I proudly represent Junior Troop 89215. Today, I will be performing I Love Play Rehearsal from Be More Chill by Joe Iconis. I love play rehearsal because it's the best, because it is fun. I love play rehearsal and I get depressed as soon as it's done. But not depressed as in like kill yourself depressed. No, I'm not into self-harm. Dude, I swagger check my arm.
My name is Evelyn Jones. I proudly represent Junior Troop 89215. I will be performing I'd Rather Be Me from the musical Mean Girls by Jeff Richman and lyrics by Neil Benjamin. Ginger overacted nice when she got nice. Well, I am surprised, this happened to me twice. It's my secret strategy, it always works because the world doesn't end, it just feels like it does.
Hello, my name is Miriam Shaheen, and I proudly represent Junior Troop 89215. I'll be presenting Pygmalion by George Bernard Shaw and Gabrielle by Liz Elt. Bring away! What do I care? I knew you'd trick me someday! Aha! Now I know how to deal with you. What a fool I was not to think of it before. You can't take away the knowledge that you gave me. You said I had a finer ear than you, and I can be civil and kind to people, which is more than you can. Aha! That's done, you Henry Higgins. Now I don't care for your bullying and your big talk. I'll advertise it in the papers. Their Duchess is only a flower girl that you taught, and she'll teach anybody to be a duchess just the same in 6 months for 1,000 guineas. Oh, when I think of myself crawling on your feet, being trampled on, when all I had to do was lift up a finger to be as good as you, I could just kick myself.
Mr. Katzander, I guarantee it, I'll be the friendliest, most dedicated greeter this Walmart has ever seen. I'm such a people person. Work with people all the time at last job. Well, I'm on business actually, selling alternative wedding dresses. I just thought it was time for a change. Well, there was sort of a misunderstanding from the last client, real bridezilla. This girl's daddy was paying for everything, so she wanted me to go all out. I made her the most gorgeous gothic ball gown you have ever seen. 15 yards to tap it up. It was dreadful, our queen. She wouldn't even burgundy. Now, you do know what burgundy looks like, right? Because I sure do. And when she comes to pick it up, you know she says to me, "What is this? I can't get married in purple." I was completely professional. I told her what she'd asked for. I told her, "Sweetie, this is burgundy." And then she starts using foul language. She says I ruined her wedding day and she can tell everybody she knows that she never gave a dress for me, blah, blah, blah. Well, she already paid and the wedding 3 days, so she has to take it. She's about to leave and something comes over me. Who the heck does she think she is? I had a Venti Cafe Americano on the counter. Hadn't even taken a sip yet, and I just fall over that dress. And wouldn't you know, it turns out her daddy's a lawyer. Apparently I caused her severe emotional stress, and the little twit must know a lot of people because business have been in the toilet. But I don't have any regrets. Seeing the look on her face was all I needed. You know, Mr. Katzander, some people piss me off. They really, really do. Maybe you have an opening in the warehouse or something?